haven't seen you.
Can you still not see me? Can you still not see me?
No, it's still loading. It's got like a loading set.
I've been with my boyfriend David for 5 years now. We stopped going out when I was 14. We met in high school. I think it is hard having a long distance relationship, but I don't think it's as hard as people make it out to be. Like, I don't find it that difficult. But you do have to put a bit more effort in.
The sun, wine for the woman who made the rain come. Seagulls sing your hearts away as wild sinners sin, the children play. Oh Lord, how they play and play for that happy day, for that happy day.
Skype and Facebook have helped quite a lot with keeping in touch with each other. Like, Facebook, it means that without even speaking to each other, we can kind of see what's going on in each other's lives, like by the photos and stuff. And I can tell he's having a good time in uni, he can tell that I'm having a good time, and things like that. And then with Skype, that's the main way we talk to each other. It's free, and it means we get to see each other on webcam and stuff as well, so it's really helpful.
I'd talk to him every single day, and it would be Skype or Facebook or things like that, just trying to keep in contact, but it would always be by internet sort of thing.
Yeah.
Or phone calls once in a while, but it was harder to call him. And so it was very much, you don't really get the emotion that goes through in whatever they're saying, like, how are you, or, oh, I did this today, or anything.
Yeah.
And so it gets sort of difficult to sort of have that image of the person that you say you like, but you sort of feel like you don't know them anymore.
Everything's a bit more complex, you know, complex than it first appears. And you would think that in the new media era, that it would be much more easy to sustain a long-term relationship, like you said, by using Skype, by Facebook, and by tweeting. But in actual fact, it just comes down to that the fact that you're in a different world, a different place, and people say things that they're not going to do, and it's very difficult to keep promises. And you know, very very quickly in your university career, you bed yourself into your university life. So going home or going to see the person that you had the relationship with isn't such a big draw anymore, because you've got your life at the university and you don't want to miss out on it. So in an odd way, it probably acts as a stress, because the person concerned is probably wondering why you're not Facebooking them, or why somebody else is on your Facebook, and why you don't want them to have access to your Facebook, and you know, who's phoning you, who's texting you. So I think it's probably more likely to be a factor of breaking up than keeping together.
If someone wanted, let's say one of my friends was in a long distance relationship, I'd support them in it.
Yeah.
The best part to a long distance relationship is just, it's really nice when you see each other when you haven't seen each other for ages.
Yeah, you'd appreciate talking to them face to face and sort of picking up their habits or emotions or just their way of being. So I'm not bitter towards it, I'm just cautious.
I think you should just go for it and try it and see how it goes, but don't expect too much from it, so just see how things work out.
So you think you can tell heaven from hell, blue skies from pain? Can you tell a green field on a cold steel rail, a smile from a veil.